Kenny, you've been involved in this machine. What's your role?
A settler operator.
And how do you setter operator and programmer? How do you find it compared to some of the other machines that you've got? Because new technology.
Yeah, it's pretty good. There's a lot more advantages with having the twin spindle, twin turret.
What are they for those that wouldn't know?
Well, speed. You can first of all you can get the parts off complete. With the other lathes we have, you have to do second and third ops.
And then there's a risk of making it mistakes, I suppose, from moving the part from machine to machine.
Plus you lose accuracy. You're doing double operations and stuff. With this, you can do you can transfer the part from spindle to spindle, so you get the part off the machine complete.
What about the fact that you've got the extra axes on here, like the Y axes, the subspindle you've mentioned, but also the tools on the top? You've got 15 on the top,
yeah,
and 12.
15 and 24 on the bottom. You can also double them up, so you can have both turrets working left or right, or either left and right.
It's an incredible amount of tools. You're not going to run out, are you? You're not going to run out of spaces.
No, it helps with the setup time because you can leave a lot of tools on the machine, and then when you're setting up, you're obviously cutting down on the setup time.
I suppose it allows you to look at a part and think, rather than I can only machine it like this because I've only got so many tools, what's the best way to machine it because I've got enough stations?
Yeah, definitely. Also, you can do balance tunneling with having twin turrets, and that can make a big difference to roughing time. You know, you can rough and finish it at the same time. You can also use one of the turrets as a tailstock or can support a part, so that could help with longer parts as well.
When I sometimes look at twin turret machines, I notice that the bottom turret doesn't necessarily have a Y axis, but you've got Y on both here, haven't you?
Well, actually, when we went to buy the machine, the part on the machine was using both power tools on one axis to cut the milling time in half. It was doing a hex, but it was doing two parts of the hex at the same time.
Is this a big learning curve for you when you?
Not really. I've done machines similar to this, threading heads similar to this before with twin spindles. So it's not a hard machine to learn. I mean, it's Fanuc, and the controls are pretty straightforward. So
when you program it, do you just like to split the machine in two? You go right and program. There's my program for the main spindle and one turret, and there's my program the other, and then you put the two together. Is that how it works?
There's actually three lines of programming. You've got the left-hand spindle, the right-hand spindle, and then the unloader. It's a separate program. So you just basically work them one at a time, and you have waiting codes so they meet up where they need to be.
I was quite surprised, Kenny, when I looked at some of the parts, the stainless parts that you're machining here on this. It's obviously quite robust as well then, as well as fast.
Yeah, it's a good quality machine. You can tell the accuracy. It's microns. I mean, you can leave a part running at night and come in the morning, the part the size is having moved. So.
And what about your tool wear as well with that? Do you experience more tool wear on this machine or less?
I'd say less. It's got a large 380 litre coolant sump, so there's a lot of power coming out of that to keep the tools cool, so it lasts a while.
Is it your favourite machine in the machine shop now? I mean, you've got, probably six or seven CNC machines here. Does this stand out?
Yeah, it's good to see the part come off the machine complete. I mean, you're not having to say, all right, now I need to do another operation. You just set up the machine. It's got a conveyor, so the parts are loaded onto a box, and then they're ready to go into inspection.
For other operators, programmers and setters, shouldn't be nervous about jumping into this sort of technology. It won't take them long to get to grips with.
No, it's pretty straightforward. I mean, it's like I say, it's Fanuc, and it's... the controls are pretty straightforward, it's pretty simple to set up and run.